Hello, Taylor here today. I'm going to try a pour. Actually, I've done a few and I've had some fails. So I am back. I'm using an old recipe that I did for really big cells, and you don't see the really big cells in the video because they didn't actually show up until much later. But this is the recipe that I used. Here's what actually happened. So if you go back to my videos and you look up really big cells, this is what actually ends up happening. You can go all the way to the end of the video and you won't, this does not look at all the same. I walked away 20 minutes later, I came back, I'm like, what in the world? So just know your pores don't always come out the way you think they will at all. Whoops, oh, goodness, I'm struggling with a lot of different little details today, but it's all gonna be fine. I'm gonna hit pause for a second while I kinda get things together. I am using all the leftover paint I had way back from that pour and some others, but it is Windsor and Newton. I believe it was one part Windsor and Newton to two parts of Liquitex gloss medium, and then hair oil is being added, and I actually didn't bring everything up to honey consistency, so it should be an interesting pour. See, that is the dirtiest pour you may ever see in your life. And it's been sitting a little bit, so I'm gonna hit pause and try to get stuff together. Okay, here's hoping that all the technical stuff behaves this time and that I can get my torch to work. Yes, it's full, but for some reason it always takes me several tries. So, tap plastic, less than a buck. Plastic, they're excess plastic. I have the paper on the back. I'll be drying it like that. You can see all that. Yay. So yeah, happy joy. Obviously, I'm not gonna stir it. I may regret that later because there's some solid stuff at the bottom, and I see a lot of dimethicone on top, which means stuff is not gonna stick. And that's not what I want to happen. But if I stir it, it'll turn into mud. See all these decisions we make as we go through the process. So I'm just gonna go hope that I'm moving that dimethicone around and hoping that when I pour, I'm gonna do a dirty flip cup. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. That seems to be the most successful for whatever reason. I don't know. Every time I think I don't have enough paint, I do. When I have too much, everything time I think I've got way too much, sometimes I don't have enough. It's always kind of an adventure. So welcome to the adventure today. It is a beautiful day. We finally got the house down to about 74 inside, which is really chilly for a lot of people, including myself. It's in the mid-90s today, and the humidity is almost non-existent. I mention that because humidity and temperature really affects the bejeebers out of your paint. Not to mention me not adding a lot of water today because I'm just kind of like, I need to use this paint up. So realize that these are subprime conditions. Kind of like the, yeah. Anyways, so here we go. Big reveal. Well, I think I'll have more than enough. And look at the dimethicone. It's all sliming up there. That's kind of looking ugly, but I've seen uglier things than this come out looking really cool. So I'm going to be optimistic in a California kind of way. Oh yeah, like totally, dude. What will be this or something better? And it's all good. Ew, not digging the crimson hue and the cadmium hue, or the crimson and cadmium hue. I've got both of those in there. Let me focus. No focus problems today. Strange sound, but I know it wasn't an earthquake. Of course, whenever anything makes a sound in California, you're like, huh, is that gonna start shaking, rattling, and rolling? Or is that just the house settling? See, I guess I should have maybe. Well, let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Let's see, and hopefully you can't hear my radio. I don't want to get anybody, especially not myself, in trouble. And I thought I just turned it down, and now it sounds really loud to me. See, that's what we get when that dimethicone hits the surface, your paint surface, whether it be canvas or plastic or whatever. If it hits first, that paint is not gonna go on there. So I'm gonna have to backfill it now, later, sometime in the future. Come on, just roll on down. So I'm gonna roll my paint slowly. Sometimes you can keep the pattern if you roll it slowly. Don't pull it because you'll just smear. So optimistically, I'm going to try to come back here. I mean, I can always paint it or backfill it after it dries and burn off that dimethicone. Hopefully you can see that and it's focusing all right. I've been having focusing issues, and that's for a whole nother video, whole nother audience. I don't really need to finish off the sides because this is acrylic. It's probably going to be popped into a frame or stacked up. So let's be optimistic. Hope this fills in. Ooh, little bit of overkill there. Adds a new element. For the most part, you make mistakes or whatever, it just adds a new interesting element. Don't get all judgy on your painting because you just never know, man. Could be having a hard day, or it could be just getting ready to blossom and bloom before your eyes. Got a lot of bubbles, got a lot of schmutz. Don't have my rag. Oh, I took it out front. I'm gonna have to wipe this on my pants so I have the most colorful pantalones that I just kind of go with. Okay, so boogers. I've got my booger removers slash bubble poppers. Paint boogers. Dimethicone boogers. That's probably a big blob of dimethicone. So let's see if we can burn that puppy off. Burn, baby, burn. Yes, me and the three tries. Come on, let's get it on 2 tries. Okay, 3 tries. Okay, 5 tries. There we go. So let's see. We don't know what's going to happen. Like I said, that last one, it looked like it was doing nothing, that I wasn't getting anything. And then eventually it just like bloomed more cells than anything. I don't know why I can't consistently get cells. I do not know. I keep trying. Now, this I know is just a really wonky paint pour because it's just a lot of leftovers. I'm trying to get rid of stuff, but at the same time, I'm still trying to get cells. I want cells. Give me cells. Give me lace. Give me something. See, a little bit's coming up there. Let's not catch the paint on fire. Okay. Well, there you have it. Not a fan of the red area. Am I going to muck it up and possibly muck it up? I'm not real happy about the ochre. Ochre is always iffy because it's kind of baby poo yellow. I'm not a fan, but I had it, so I wanted to use it. I had the mix and I wanted to use it up. Oh, there's something kind of interesting right there. If you can see that, I didn't know. So that's kind of has pseudo possibilities. See, is it done moving? That's the other question. Oh, it is not done moving. So of course that's going to elongate any cells that I did have. Kind of get rid of some of that baby poo yellow that I'm not a fan of. Go baby poo yellow. Huh, got some weirdness going on. I probably have paint boogers and oh, I don't want to lose that cool spot though. It looks like a Jupiter spot or something. I kind of think it's cool, man. Let's not lose it, man. Hold on to it, man. Spread it out, man. Well, maybe that ochre might actually give us something pleasant we weren't expecting. Or not. It's kind of a strange color combo. You know, I can look at the color wheel until I turn purple, and I still don't, still don't seem to have a grasp. Even when I follow the recipes. Use this complimentary. Use this whatever jigget. What's it say over there? I'm always a, yeah, sure, I'll try this. It's right next to each other. Don't mix that. Okay, they're on opposite sides. Well, now I'm like, okay. Oh, but it doesn't work when I pour it. So me and my color wheel. Did I? Yeah, well, I guess I didn't. Whatever. Let's see. Triadic? I'm pseudo triadic with my red and my blue. And then I have, well, I thought I, no, I guess I had no purple. Anyway. Yeah, me and the color wheel don't seem to get along either. Me and cells aren't getting along lately, and me and the blooming color wheel. I have been challenged forever. I've been doing artsy stuff since I was like 6, and I still am challenged. Well, I didn't get to do the super, you know, no MFA or anything like that. Gotta have a dream, but then there's reality and paying the rent. Ooh, look at that. That's kind of interesting. That was the dimethicone finally floating. It looks like maybe I put too much dimethicone in. I did use 2 different hair gels, so that might not have been a good idea. Ooh, I can just smell that. Whoosh, flambe. Yeah, we've got some stuff coming up now. Let's get getting more interesting. Or if I walk away, it'll continue to change like the last one did. Yeah, we're getting some kind of Coolidge stuff here, some kind of agate effect. It's always interesting when it continues to change. See, is there still movement? Yes, there is still movement. It's a funky red thing. Well, let's just let it move. Let's go with the flow, let it develop and become its own. Woo woo. Just let it keep moving. I think there's dimethicone trapped under there. I don't know. Focus. I'm not sure if that's a... So we're losing some cool blue notes in favor of... Oh, I did have green in there. See? Things just sink to the bottom. You just never know where stuff's going to end up at the end of the day. It's going to end up wherever the heck it wants to. That's interesting. Oh, did I actually... Maybe I must have burned. I've got a little bit of a skin there. See? I don't know if you can see that or not. The light is such a challenge. I don't know. Let's see if I bring it up closer. See there? I got my little torch. See the wrinkles? Can you see the wrinkles? Not my wrinkles, the painting's wrinkles. Yeah, so that's where I guess over-torched and caused a film to form over that area. So now we've stretched out that red a lot. Stretched out that ochre, baby poo yellow ochre, kind of migrated and did its own thing. And I definitely put in too much dimethicone because it's actually managed to... damn it. Excuse my French. So let's do a little backfill there. Shoot. Oh, boogers, I did it again. I'm really good at doing that, dropping when I'm not paying attention. I only seem to do it when I'm doing videos, though. I don't know if that's good or bad. Shoot, now it's going to be all demented-ish. So yeah, I definitely put in too much dimethicone and such. And I over-torched the... I was trying to get rid of that dimethicone lump, because I don't think that that's a booger. I think it's a dimethicone lump. Yep, see, there's nothing to pull up. So it's a lump of dimethicone that's just kind of doming underneath. It's doming, man. It's doming. Huh, interesting. And that'll kind of meld in and fade away. Sometimes it adds an extra element. So it'll be interesting to... Ooh, that was a nasty skin I left. So, don't get your torch too close. That's what'll happen. You'll get a kind of not pleasant-looking area. Yeah, and don't use too much dimethicone, because then you get dimethicone bubbles, which means that the paint may peel. So when it dries, hopefully I can pop it, apply some alcohol after it's much more cured, and get that dimethicone off of the surface of the acrylic. Huh? Meh. I've had a lot of meh today. It's a meh day. Anyways, well, thank you for joining me. Oh my god, 13 minutes of this? I'm really sorry. I hope you learned something. I hope you have a great time. Don't give up pouring. Keep on pouring. Rock that pouring. And enjoy your day.